I'm an account manager at one of the FANG tech companies.
How much do you make doing that?
So I have a base of 160K and then I have about 100K in equity.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a consultant.
And how much do you make doing this?
Ballpark 100 to 140.
Well, actually, what you do for a living?
I'm a marketing consultant.
Roughly how much do you make on a monthly basis as a marketing consultant in Amsterdam?
Maybe like 10K or something.
What do you do for a living?
I'm associate partner at
Okay. If we may guess, are you making $200,000?
No, more than that.
$300,000?
Around about.
In sabhi job roles mein, you can easily earn over $100,000. And if we compare this with India, then this is what you'll get.
So what do you do?
So I'm a financial analyst at a US-based finance firm.
Okay, and like if someone wants to get into this field, how much salary they can expect?
So if they are completing from the top universities, the tier one universities, like IIMs, they can expect around 25 lakhs per annum.
What do you do? I've been working as a strategy consultant at an MNC for past 2 years. If someone wants to get into this field, how much salary they can expect? Roughly around 20 to 25 LPA.
So the average salary after an MBA in India is around 25 to 30 lakhs per annum, which is not at all a bad amount. However, the pain point here is that you'll get this salary only after completing your MBA from top B school like IIM, ISB or SPJ. Or in sabhi colleges ka acceptance rate below 0.5%. Ab tum log bologe wo sab to theek hai, but is cheez ka solution kya hai? Chinta mat karo, wo bhi batata hu. The solution is doing your business degree from abroad. Now you must be thinking, abroad se padhne bol to diya, but kaun si degree pursue karni hai aur kaun se colleges ko target karna hai, ye sab kaun batayega? Chinta mat karo, wo bhi main bataunga. But before going ahead, if you guys are planning to study abroad at top B schools, that you don't want to miss our free AI based profile evaluation tool. It will assess your strengths, weaknesses and suggest you schools to improve your chances. The link is in the description box below. Let's start the video by discussing 5 high paying degrees abroad. Here are the 5 high paying degrees abroad. Let's start with MBA. So average MBA salary abroad is around $150,000, and if we talk about the average tuition fees, then it is estimated around $96,000. For an MBA, you'll need a work experience of around 3 to 5 years, and this is mandatory for almost all universities abroad. Top countries for an MBA degree include USA, UK and Canada. Next up, we have MIM or Masters in Management. After doing an MIM degree, you can expect an average salary of around $90,000 against the tuition fees of somewhere around $50,000. And the best part about this degree is, this is ideal for fresh graduates because you can pursue this degree without even having a work experience. However, if you have work experience of around 0 to 2 years, then you'd be considered as an ideal candidate. Top countries for MIM degree are US and UK. Next up, we have MFIN or Masters in Finance. After doing this degree, you can expect an average salary of around $125,000 against the tuition fees of somewhere around $75,000. Now talking about the WorkX requirement, then you need around 0 to 2 years of work experience. And again, this degree is also ideal for fresh graduates. Now top countries for Masters in Finance are US and UK. On number 4, we have MSBA or Masters in Business Analytics. Average starting salary for this degree abroad is around $125,000. And if we talk about the tuition fees, then it is economical and estimated around $66,000. WorkX requirement for this degree is between 0 to 2 years, and the best country for this degree is US and UK. Lastly, we have MEM or Masters in Engineering Management. This degree can easily land you a job of around $115,000 against the tuition fees of somewhere around $68,000. Now talking about the work experience, then again, you need 0 to 2 years of work experience to pursue this degree. And if we talk about the top country for this degree, then US is the ideal country for this degree. So there you have it, the list of 5 high paying degrees that can really skyrocket your career. But the most important question is still to be answered. How to get admission in top USB schools, especially when the admission process is way too competitive with an acceptance rate of around 7 to 8%? Don't worry, our team is here to help students interested in doing MBA or any business major from abroad. Click the link in the video description to book a free 20-minute strategy session with our study abroad expert. We'll guide you through choosing the right school, writing standout essays, SOPs, LORs, and offer personalized advice on schools, GMAT prep, and scholarship. Now, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe to MIMSA for more study abroad content like this.